bit earlier that he named his phantom Jorge or something like that. But it's okay. We
Shout
love
out
the
to Jorge.
Absolutely, we love Jorge.
Yeah.
But anyways, playing Diddy Kong.
Oh. I think this is going to be a pretty strong matchup because Diddy Kong's really good at controlling like mid-range space, and that's all Zelda wants to set up in. So I think it's going to be about keeping a mid-range the entire time, and that's how you're going to push the biggest lead against Zelda. Wait for Zelda to do something punishable in that range, then just toss in a banana, and that could be so much percent. So Gretch, I think it's all, yeah, we're going to have to see how patient Gretch is to wait, or not Gretch, sorry, Messiah is to wait for Gretch to do something.
Absolutely, and we already see a little bit of that patience coming in right now for both of these players. A little bit of a lead from Messiah. Messiah is just kind of throwing Gretch for a loop in this disadvantage here. It's not, you know, everything, but they're literally just taking their hit for a hit. They don't need to do as much as they don't need to do to if they don't want to.
Yeah, and that fair actually caught the banana, which is nice for Gretch because without the banana, it's hard for Messiah to close in the space.
Absolutely, and just trying to kind of control this a little bit more. Messiah has banana in hand, and it's feeling a little bit scary. Getting a little too aggressive there, but just still trying to control this ledge as best as possible. And just, I really do love how Gretch is honestly kind of just, you know, trying not their their best to not really do too much when they're at the ledge. Just take their time, you know, as they may be in disadvantage for a little bit, but they do have Jorge, so they can use Jorge as many times as they need to.
Yeah, and you saw at the start of the match, Messiah had a lead playing the mid range, but then on the ledge, they were so insistent on pushing the aggression on Gretch, and Gretch capitalized off that. Now Gretch has a slight lead. Ooh, and a really tough edge guard spot to be in. Ooh, gonna clip the jump. That's just, not the stop.
Absolutely, and they put themselves in that position. They were trying to go for a little bit of the tweak. I don't know, we have to dub that the tweak, only because Tweak has made that move so prevalent. Banana to down air on ledge. Just amazing. And definitely love the attempt, but definitely need to work a little bit of an execution from that. But just trying their best to take their stock. They don't have banana now, and that could have been a very bad choice if Gretch would have used it properly.
Messiah right here, they can't let themselves they can't let themselves get out of control with aggression to try and seal out the stock. Otherwise, they're going to be in this spot right here with the ball rating taking 62. Ooh. A cheeky barrel right there. Really good if Zelda's setting up Knight under the platform.
Absolutely. And, you know, they were trying to go for that for a little bit, but they didn't get it too much. And they were also kind of putting themselves in the bad position just kind of for going for that because Zelda's charging Phantom. Phantom is kind of scary. You don't want to be directly going straight into Jorge's position if, you know, you're vulnerable at that point. But going to lose that second stop.
Right there.
Absolutely. You know, they look like Messiah needs to take this a little bit more of a different approach because they are in a disadvantageous position. They're stock down and, you know, Gretch has the lead.
Yeah, they're just not stopping holding forward and it's just going to keep chipping away way faster than they're going to be doing damage to Gretch. So Messiah's going to need to completely change the pace. It's not a matter of not going in, but it's about picking the spots to go in. Messiah is just picking every spot they can.
Absolutely. That's exactly what I was going to point out. See, Gretch has been used. I think that might have been the reason why they went to Smashville. I thought it was supposed to be PS2, but it's kind of whatever at this point. But either way, Gretch was really using Phantom, as you see right there, and they charge it. And because Phantom actually hits above the ledge, that actually stops a lot of approaches. So if you're trying to be very aggressive at the ledge, that actually stops a lot of approaches. And because it was almost, you know, really well timed,
nice and handsy,
just missed the tech at 150, 60, 70%. Missed the tech, very sad. And they were trying a little bit too hard. Definitely looks like they need to work on that small part of execution. And wow. That was a very convincing game coming in from Gretch.
Yeah, that was just the classic tale of Zelda having a lead and not knowing what to do about that. Because it was so many times, especially landing on Zelda, a B at a shield or a parry grab, it's really prevalent. So it's just, you got to know that you control mid-range really well as Diddy with the mix-ups of banana toss and monkey flip and such. And Messiah is going to have to realize that that's where they play the game. Mm-hmm. They play the game slightly away from Zelda, but able to get in when Zelda makes a mistake, not giving Zelda a bunch of free openings by landing on her.
Absolutely. And we see the counter bait to PS2. Wait, wrong stage. We're at Town and City. I like this counter pick. They have a little bit more space to play around, especially considering that they do have the triplats. Very weird monkey flip there. But they definitely have a little bit more space to just move around and kind of control what Zelda wants to do after she actually sends out Jorge. So, still not too much of an even percent. It looks like Gretch is definitely doing a little bit better now than they were the first game when, they just started playing.
Ooh.
And gonna get that down air, not gonna follow two ups after that afterwards, but it looks like Messiah is actually trying to use Banana in order to kind of just catch the teleport. It just hasn't been working too often.
You mean like the Z-drop, like
yeah.
there and stuff?
They haven't Z-dropped. I think they only Z-dropped it once, and yeah, it just hasn't been working out too well for them. You know, it's very nice when you want to get all fancy and whatnot, but just need to be a little bit more wary about how you actually go about that.
Yeah, and one thing Messiah can realize is after Zelda sends out the Knight, if she's just standing there, she'll be in lag, and that's a really prime time to toss a banana. So I think if Messiah can maybe implement, like, good short hop backs or even a parry on the Phantom, it can go a long way, but right now they're just not able to weave around it.
And another thing as well is that Gretch actually hasn't been displacing Phantom. I don't think they've displaced Phantom this entire set, if I remember correctly. And that's actually one of the most important things to Zelda as a character. Being able to displace Phantom is one of the most useful tools when playing this character because you actually end up avoiding a lot of projectiles. So one of those projectiles being Monkey Flip. But
wow.
We are going to see that. Very nice. Taking
first
that first
stock.
Absolutely. And immediately calling it out, that jump, just going to take that stock right back. This is my stock. I don't know. What are you doing?
Yeah,
I don't know.
Regardless of losing the stock right after, I think this is a good note for Messiah because they started this game off like at 100 when Gretch is at 40 and managed to bring it back to even stocks. So I think they're starting to feel a bit more confidence. And as long as they can keep this up and be a bit smarter with their aggression, this could be game three.
Absolutely. Definitely need to show a little bit more patience here because, you know, you are on a platform where you have so much room to just sit there and just not do anything. And I know that sounds so boring, but as much as you kind of want to hold forward, it's a little bit more of the smarter option to just stay on the platform. Do you not feel comfortability in just staying on a platform?
You know what's not boring, Jazzy? Winning.
Absolutely.
And that's what you got to do sometimes. You got to stand there.
Uh-huh. I know what they said was right. I mean, you got to take whatever you got to do. You got to do what you got to do to win. And I don't know. It may be boring, but it's just what we might win. Oh, who doesn't love to win? I don't know.
Oh.
And that was such a good back air coming in from Gretch, just getting that second stock off. And we see a little bit of a repeat from the first game where Gretch has their second stock and not going to get that. That was super close and going to miss the
really
punish on that.
String.
Yes,
yeah,
absolutely.
This is looking a bit wrapped right now. Unless Messiah really is able to take a breather and readjust their gameplay, Gretch has so much momentum going into this last stock with such a big lead.
Absolutely. They need to be a little bit more careful about how they choose their disadvantage situations, and they also need to be careful about how they actually choose their advantageous position. Sorry. Because they had a lot of situations where they had Gretch at the ledge, but they can't actually do anything with it. You know, it's nice to just sit there and kind of make it feel a little bit more threatening to just, you know, have Banana in hand, but I don't even think they had Banana in hand the whole time. You know, it's just one of those things where, like, you really need to know in order to actually really execute well, especially since Diddy's not one of those characters where you can just pick up and do amazing with. You know what I mean?
Yeah, Diddy's definitely a character that takes a bit of time to learn their neutral because it's so unique. Ooh, okay, that was nice.
Very nice. And at a comfortable percent, you know, you are still in kill percent, but you still can make this back. As long as you're being very careful, this is definitely within the realm of possibilities for Messiah. And
that was not the best DI on that dash attack.
Yeah, that was looking a little bit still a little bit scary. Yeah, I don't know. That's just
that's a game.
Yeah, but that was definitely a good on Messiah. They definitely put out their – they played their heart out. I don't know. It kind of looked like it. They played their best.
There was some adaptation coming from game one to game two, and it was a little bit closer. But it was really that, like, after Gretsch took Messiah's second stock, they got that, like, 60% string because Messiah, right after losing the stock, just held forward and right there. Mm-hmm. I think they were trying to roll away and probably were holding towards the blast zone, mm-hmm. if I had to guess. But, yeah, really rough DI.
Yeah, and I really love how Gretsch actually caught the banana, and they actually recognized that, you know, Messiah actually just wanted to monkey flip, and they definitely did call that out, and they jumped over it. Banana, boom. Dead. That's death.
That's death. You know, an interesting thing I saw at least one time was Peanut used. Actually, if a Peanut's there and Zelda sets up the knight, if she gets hit, that knight's gone. And I think that was actually a tool that was not used enough, and that I didn't quite realize until watching the match when I saw it happen once. If you throw out a Peanut, Zelda can't put Knight out. She has to deal with the Peanut first, and that's a really good tool. Even you can bait out reflectors, you can bait out shield and run up grab. So I think Messiah, if you're watching this VOD, that's something to consider for such a defensive matchup as Zelda.